Coming to our second abstract, abstract 8 of the Genetto Humanized session. Next slide, please. This is the PACE-B trial published in the Lancet Oncology in September 2019, which is the patient-reported acute toxicity in PACE-B, an international phase 3 randomized controlled trial comparing stereotactic body radiotherapy to conventionally fractionated or moderately hypofractionated radiotherapy, CFM-HRT, for localized prostate cancer, published by D.H. Brand et al. Next slide, please. The PACE-B trial schema included 874 localized prostate carcinoma patients, T1C to T2C, T-stage, Gleason score of less than equal to 3 plus 4, PSA less than equal to 20, MRI stage, ADT was not allowed, with performance status of 0 to 1. Site decision for radical radiotherapy, the patients were randomized into 1:1 ratio, into either the SBRT arm or the CFM-MHRT arm. In the SBRT arm, the patients were given 36.25 gray in 5 fractions over 1 to 2 weeks. And in the CFM-MHRT arm, the patients received 78 gray in 39 fractions over 7.8 weeks or 62 gray 20 fractions over 4 weeks. 62 gray 20 fractions 4 weeks were introduced in 2016 after the CHIP trial. The primary endpoint were biochemical and clinical progression-free survival. The secondary endpoint were overall survival and prostate cancer-specific survival and acute and late toxicity and ADT commencement. Next slide, please. The planning was through IGRT and IMRT-SBRT mandatory with recommended fiducial markers followed by planning MRI approximately 7 days after that. Next slide, please. The CTV size was determined by the risk. Low risk group patients had CTV with prostate only, and in the intermediate risk group, CTV involved prostate plus 1 centimeter of the seminal vesicle. Next slide, please. The per protocol concert of the PACE-B trial, 874 patients were randomized into the two arms, the conventional arm and the SBRT arm. In the conventional arm, 441 patients were involved, of which 16 did not receive RT, and 2 patients crossed over to the SBRT arm. Any patient who received more than one fraction were a total of 432, and these patients were further analyzed. In the SBRT arm, 433 patients were considered, of which 10 did not receive trial RT. 9 patients crossed over to the conventional arm, and 416 patients received more than one fraction and were included in the analysis. One patient received both SBRT and the conventional RT due to setup issues. Next slide, please. These were mostly the intermediate risk groups and that too the favorable risk groups. In the conventional arm, 91.4% patients were the above the intermediate risk. T2B to T2C 52%, Gleason 3 plus 4 81%, PSA 10 to 20 nanogram per ml 31%. In the SBRT arm, 92.1% of the patients comprised of intermediate risk group, of which T2B to T2C lesion was in 54%, Gleason 3 plus 4 83%, and PSA of 10 to 20 nanogram per ml 31%. Next slide, please. More fiducial markers were used in the SBRT arm compared to the conventional arm. In the conventional arm, there were 57% patients with fiducial, and in the SBRT arm, 73% patients with the fiducial. Next slide, please. Larger CTV to PTV margin was used in the conventional arm. In the conventional arm, the isometric margin of less than equal to 5 mm was used in 16.4% and in the SBRT arm 98.5%, except for the posterior margin, wherein it was less than equal to 5 mm in the conventional arm 72.5% and in the SBRT arm 99.5%. Next slide, please. The delivered regimes by arm was in the conventional arm, it was the 78 gray 39 fraction 28.9% and 62 gray 20 fraction received by 69.2% of the patient. Off protocol was in 1.9%. In SBRT arm, less than 1% off protocol patients and more than 99% of the patients received 36.25 gray over 1 to 2 weeks. Next slide, please. Now, the patients, they were then further compared for IPSS with changes from baseline compared at 4, 6, 8 and 12 weeks. In these patients, the CFM-MHRT arm is represented by the red line and blue is represented by the SBRT arm. Next slide, please. It was found, next slide please. It was found that at the end of the 12 weeks, the arms showed equal IPSS scoring. Next slide please. Next slide please. Yes, in the EPIC 26 changes from the baseline score, it was found that the urinary incontinence, obstruction, bother, bowel, sexual and hormonal changes were initially seen in the four weeks in the SBRT arm and the CFM MHRT arm. Next slide please. The EPIC minimally clinically important deterioration, it was at week 12, it was seen that urinary incontinence with 8-point reduction was present in 20.7% of the patient in the conventional arm and 15.9% of the patient in the SBRT arm. Urinary obstructive features were present in 34.4% of the conventional arm and 34.2% of the SBRT arm, with bowel symptoms present in 28.3% of the conventional arm and 28.1% of the SBRT arm. Next slide, please. There was no statistically significant differences. Next slide, please. Now, the conclusion of the PACE B trial is that it is the first randomized phase 3 trial examining 5-fraction SBRT versus the standard of care conventional or moderate hypofractionated radiotherapy. There was no statistically significant differences seen in patient-reported outcome measures during the acute toxicity window, agrees with previously reported CRO data. Follow-up is ongoing for primary endpoint, biochemical or clinical failure and late toxicity. Next slide, please. Next slide, please.